Next topic is a comparison of fractions. So before going for the fractions, first we'll take the word comparison. Okay. In your daily life, where you will use this comparison? Suppose you and your brother, you and your sister is there. Suppose if your father or mother brought any chocolate. If they brought the same chocolate, then there is no problem. But if they bring a little bit slight another company, then the comparison will start. You given more for the sister, otherwise you given the more for the brother, you will do as like a comparison. If we come for the mass, suppose if I take the two caps, these two caps, and the two caps I taken from the same company, and these two caps are the equal. If we compare these two, then these two are equal. If I take these two toys, see, I taken the two toys from the same company and the same model. Okay, then if we compare these two, then these two are equal. Okay, it's a one type of the comparison. Now I'll take another. See, here it is a small oil bottle, coconut oil bottle. Here one is a big one. So if we compare these two, then which one is a bigger and which one is a smaller? I think everybody you can recognize very easily. This one is a smaller one and this one is the bigger one. It's very easy. Yes, it is a general life. Now we will apply the same thing for our mathematics. Now here I take in wooden blocks. Okay, think that this is one chocolate, this is another chocolate. Okay, from that here now I ate this part. Okay, now you compare these two chocolates. So which one is a lesser one and which one is a greater one? So obviously everybody can say directly, see, this one is a lesser one, this one is a greater one. So now I will show this one in a fraction. See, here the total number of parts is how many? 4. Here total number of the parts is how many? 4. From that, here I ate 1, so remaining is how many? 3. Here total as it is there, so 4. So 3 by 4 4 by 4, which one is a greater one? 4 by 4 is a greater one, 3 by 4 is a lesser one. Now I'll apply the another. Suppose you and your sister is there. Okay, your father brought a chocolate. Your father bought two equal, means same company chocolates. Okay, from that you ate one part and your brother or sister ate two parts. Okay, now who ate more? Okay, who ate more means, same here the total number of parts is 4 only, here also 4 only. Here number of remaining parts is 3, here number of remaining parts is 2. Here this guy ate more, but when we compare these two now, means after eating remaining part, okay, see, now this part is more than this part. I think got an idea. Yes, how I am doing comparison, did you get an idea? Okay, we'll take another example. Think that your parent, they brought a dairy silk, so it will be in this much length only. Just assume it and feel it. Okay, from that you and your brother or sister, okay, you are using this chocolate. So total here, how many parts are there? Total 8 parts are there. Here also 8. From this you ate 2 parts, your brother ate 4 parts. You ate how many parts? Only 2. Your brother ate 4. So same, when your brother ate 2 parts, here remaining parts is how many? 6. Here remaining parts is how many? 4. So after eating that, you will compare whose chocolate is a little bit bigger one. Okay, now I am also doing the same thing. Okay, see here, this one is 6 blocks are there, so 6 by 8, here 4. So which one is a bigger one here? 6 by 8 is a bigger one. Yes, because you ate very less, so that's why your chocolate is a bigger one. So once again we'll apply the little bit more. Suppose from this you ate once again the 2. Your brother or sister, they ate more 2 pieces. Okay, now how much remains? From the total 8, here only 4 remains. Here 2 remains. So 2 by 8. Total number of the parts is 8. From that remaining 6 part 8, so 2 parts remains. Here the from the 8, 4 parts 8 and the remaining is 4 remains. Now also see. In the third, means after 1 hour, okay, you ate total only 1 part left. But your brother or sister, they did not eat. They left as it is. Now, if you write this one, see this is 1 by 8th part and this is 2 by 8. Now, see, if you compare this, here numerator is bigger one. So, this side, because denominator is the same. Got an idea? Here, one thing you want to remember that, everybody, when we are applying, see, denominator is the same one. Denominator is the same. See, numerator here, it is a 4. It is a bigger one. So, I kept the symbol is a greater than. Here, the denominators are the same. 8, 8. And numerator here, 1. Here, the 2. 1 is a lesser one. So, that's why I kept the less than symbol. I think everybody got an idea about, brief idea about the comparison of the fractions. Now we will go for the original problems. Okay, here first compare the 2 by 5 and 3 by 7. What we want to do? Compare. So the basic principle is, means when you are going to attempt, first we want to see the denominators are equal or not. If it is equal, then we can do how we kept before na chocolate one, as like you can keep directly. But the when the denominators are not equal, then you must and should make it the denominators equal by the, see, equivalent fractions is there na, by applying that. Okay, here I am going to do that. See, 2 by 5 and here the 3 by 7. 2 by 5, 3 by 7. See, because why I am applying this direct technique, here the denominator 5 and 7, these two are the co-prime numbers. Co-prime numbers. So, this fraction, entire fraction is, means this total fraction, I am multiplying and dividing by the 7, this number. And this total fraction, I am going to multiply by this 5. Multiply and divide. How I am writing, once you observe it, see 2 by 5 into, see it is a 7, here also 7. Means 7, 7 cancel, then once again we will get the same one, that is 2 by 5. Here it is a 3 by 7. It is a 3 by 7. With what number we want to multiply? 5 and downside also 5. Suppose if I cut the 5, 5 table 5, 5 cut means once again we will get the 3 by 7. So now it will become 14 by 35. It will become 15 by 35. 7 5 is 35. Now, see, denominators are equal. 35, 35, same. Now, I can compare the numerator. See, 14, 15. Which one is a bigger one? 15. So, I can keep the greater than symbol this side. See, this symbol shows this side is a greater one. This side is a smaller one. Always when we are writing, this side means for the symbol. I am not saying for the number. Suppose some people, they may think, suppose if I write this, now it is 15 and 14 as like. If I write as like, suppose here the 7 and 8, means smaller number side this one, vertex, and for the bigger number side is a open one. See, here the bigger number side, this open one, for the smaller number side, this a vertex. So everybody remember that, got an idea? So from this, finally we can conclude the answer. See, 14 by 35 means this, 2 by 5. And 15 by 35 means 3 by 7. In this, which one is the greater one? See, 3 by 7. So, 3 by 7 is a greater one. Same problem, once again I'll do in another method. Same, the key is make a denominator equal. Some people they will do as like also. Suppose 5, 7. So this method, suppose here I use this one when the denominators are the co-prime numbers. Otherwise we can go for this method also. Here, see, 5 ones are 7 ones are. So 5 into 7, 35. What is this? LCM. Okay. Now we can go for as like, there's a 2 by 5 can be written as, see, 2 by 5, when this 5 means the denominator will become 35, so if you multiply by 7, so upside also multiply, then it is 14 by 35. So next one is 3 by 7 can be written as, three by seven. See, when 7 will become 35, if we multiply it by the 5, so when we multiply it by the numerator 5, then denominator also we want to multiply the 5. So 5 cancel. So then it is a 15 by 35. Now if we compare, see, 14 by 35 is lesser than 15 by 35. See, 14 by 35 means what? 2 by 5. And 15 by 35 means what? 3 by 7. So 2 by 5 is a lesser one than the 3 by 7. I wrote here the two numbers. First one is a natural number, that is a 1, and 2 by 3. 2 by 3 means what? A proper fraction. Numerator is less than the denominator. See, one more word came, that is proper fraction. By seeing this, just you should say the answer without doing. See, I'll keep this directly. See, 1 is greater than 2 by 3. 1 is greater than 2 by 3. Okay, next one also I'm taking. Five by six two. I want to compare these two numbers. Okay, which one is a smaller and which one is a lesser? See, directly I am writing here. 5 by 6 is a lesser one, and 2 is a greater one. Third one, 13. See, here the next number is 13 and 21 by 25. See, one is a natural number and one is a proper fraction. So blindly I am keeping that number is a greater one. Okay, here now my question is, how I am able to keep that answer directly without doing? Without doing, I am keeping the symbol there directly. How I am keeping that? Can you guess, anybody? Otherwise, can I explain? Okay. I will explain. Suppose first one I will take. See, one by one, and two by three. If we do 2 by 3, see, zero decimal, and then only I will get here the zero. So 3 6 18, 2 remains 20, 6 18. So it's a go on. The value is how much? 0.66. 0.66. 0.66. This value is 1. So generally we know that 1 is greater than decimal. Now I'll check the second one. Once you see 5 by 6, so 5 here, so I'm keeping decimal, so then 0. 6 is 48, then I got here the 2, so then 0. Then 6 3 is 18, and once again 2. 6 3 is 18. It's go on. Okay, here the 6 by 5 value means when I am comparing 6 by 5 and 2, 6 by 5 value is 0.833, and here the 2. So always whole number is greater than. If you have the doubt, once again I will check the 13 and 21 by 25. Here the 13 and 25 21. So decimal 0. 25 is 200. So 10 remains. So one more 0. 25 4 is 100. See, anyway 13 and 0.84. So 13 is a greater one. Got an idea? So by this we can generalize as like any whole number, any natural number and proper fraction. Natural number and proper fraction, if we compare, always natural number is greater than the proper fraction, because proper fraction value will be 0 point something to the up to the 1 only. Means that a proper fraction value will be lay between 0 to 1. So we can conclude that I am writing here 0 proper fraction less than 1. Means it is a important one. Proper fraction value, where it will lie? It will be lay between 0 and 1. It won't cross. So by this technique I can write the answer very easily without doing. So next topic, now I am taking a 0 and a proper fraction. Same 0, any proper fraction, suppose 1 by 2, suppose 3 by 5 and 0, 10 by 11 0, 0, 5 by 6. What I am taking here, 1 is a 0 and another number is a proper fraction. The proper fraction, it may be how much big also, no problem. The already we concluded that proper fraction value means lay between the 0 and 1. So now I want to keep that which is a lesser one and which is a greater one. Okay, 0 and 1 by 2. So here the proper fraction is a greater one. See, simply we can write, means we can conclude as like, if we compare the proper fraction and 0, then always the proper fraction is a greater one. So we can write as like, see, 0
proper fraction, then always
proper fraction is a greater one. It's a second technique. So next one is, next one I'm taking one and proper fraction, one and proper fraction.
See, I'm writing here the one and 2/3. Suppose 115/120. Here one. Here I'm taking 1111/1112. Here the one. Here the one.
Yeah, here I taken the four examples. Means we are comparing one and a proper fraction. We no need the number. The number it whatever may be. If it is a proper fraction, it is enough for us. So now one and proper fraction. Proper fraction value will be always lay between the 0 and 1. So now what can I write the answer here? I think you can guess by seeing only. Proper fraction value will be less than the 1. Proper fraction value will be less than the 1. So 1 is always greater than 1. See how easily I kept the answer. Got an idea? So I'll conclude this statement. So 1 proper fraction. So 1 is always greater than 1. Suppose if you write proper fraction this side, and 1 this side, as like also vice versa. Got an idea? Okay. The next concept is a proper fraction, improper fraction. See, already you learned about proper fraction and improper fraction. So you know the definition also. In a proper fraction, numerator is always less than the denominator. In improper fraction, numerator is always greater than the denominator. Now we'll check that one once. Yeah, here I taken the four examples. So one is a proper fraction and second one is a improper fraction. Sometimes I taken the first one as improper fraction, second one as a proper fraction. Now I want to compare these two fractions. Okay, so I am going to write the answer directly. See, first one is a 2/3. 2/3 means a numerator is less than the denominator. So then we call that one as a proper fraction. Next one is a 5/4. 5/4 means a numerator is greater than the denominator. So that is a improper fraction. So generally we can say the one statement, always the proper fraction is a less than the improper fraction. So now I am writing directly. See, proper fraction is a lesser one and improper fraction one is a greater one. In a second case, you can observe here, that is 1179/2001. So according to the definition, it is a proper fraction because numerator is a less than the denominator. In the next case, see, 3578/3577. Numerator is greater one and denominator is a smaller one. So then it is a improper fraction. So I can write the answer directly. Improper fraction is a greater one. See, in the third case, I taken 7/6. 7/6 means 7 is a numerator, 6 is a denominator. Numerator is greater than denominator. So then this is what? It is a improper fraction. Here 1/5, it's a 1 is a numerator and 5 is a denominator. It is a proper fraction. So 7/6 is an improper fraction. Improper fraction only greater one. So next fourth one. Here I taken 13/12. So numerator is greater than the denominator. So then we say this is a improper fraction. 10/11. So numerator is a less than the denominator. So it is a proper fraction. We know that improper fraction is a greater one. So here my question: how I concluded this statement? Are you able to guess, anybody? Otherwise, can I say? Yeah. Here, how I wrote the answer, once I'll explain. I taken here that improper fraction. Already you know that the proper fraction lay between the 0 and the 1. So, once we'll check for the improper fraction. Improper fraction is 5 divided by 4. So, with the 4 table. So, 4 1's are 4. So, 1 remains decimal 0. 4 2's are 8. 2 remains 0. 4 5's are 20. Means, already we know one, that is a proper fraction. It lay between the 0 and 1. But improper fraction, once you check it, it is the more than 1. 1 or more than 1. So, once I will check another one. Here, I taken the 13/12. So, 12 1's are 12. So, here the 13 minus 2 is a 1. So, decimal 0. So, 10 it won't go. So, I am keeping one more 0. Here also 1 0. 12, 9's are 108. But, 100 is there. 12 8's are 4. It's a go on. So, here we can conclude that improper fraction always is a 1 or greater than 1. Mostly it will be the greater than 1. So, by that statement, I wrote that all the answers directly. So, if we write a proper fraction and improper fraction as like, see, proper fraction improper fraction, so always improper fraction only greater one. If we write a downside, means see, improper fraction and proper fraction. If we take as like improper fraction only, always a greater one. So, if you remember this logic, you can write for the any number directly. Till now we learned that three principles. Here the more is there. We'll continue in next topic. Dear children, here I given the homework problems. So, I given 1 to 14 questions I given. So, different logics. With the different logic only you can give the answer. So, my condition is without doing any calculation. Means don't put the pen on a paper for the calculation. Okay. Just give the answer directly by using the property what I explained. So, if you use the property, then you can keep the symbol that less than or the greater than very easily in the given boxes. And some student they may feel that sir given the some question repeatedly. No, yaar. So there the answer is changing. So remember that and completed this homework. And thank you and have a nice day.